the topic of this video is drawing live pictures using AI. I've changed the layout a bit to be able to see the preview of the generated image larger. I'm clicking on the live option in the menu right here. With this red button, you can record every step you take and turn it into a Krita animation, and then make a video. I'm going to press the play button directly. This way, an AI image will be generated based on what I draw with my brush. I'm going to draw mountains as the background, then a forest and a treehouse. I filled the gap with fill. The shape is still insufficient, so I'll guide it with a prompt. If I don't write a prompt, irrelevant results can come up. I'll create a new layer and continue. I chose green color to draw grass. I'm organizing the layer names in an understandable way. I found the sky color after a bit of effort. Now let me draw clouds. Now I want to draw a forest on the slopes of the mountains. I'm choosing a suitable green. Using a scattered brush might be more appropriate. As you can see, the forest was drawn immediately because I added it to the prompt beforehand. Whereas the shape I drew doesn't resemble a forest. Even though I'm not skilled, I enjoy being able to draw pictures like this. Now I'm going to draw the wooden cabin. Instead of a brush, I can also use squares and lines. I'm drawing a pathway. Now I'm going to draw a tree. I drew the trunk in a primitive way. Since there's a lot of green in the background, I decided to draw the tree pink. This didn't work. I need to find a more voluminous brush. A cherry tree. By changing the seed with this dice button, I can see different drawings. By changing the strength value, I can adjust how much my drawing will be followed. When I set it to 20, there wasn't much change. When I go above 50, a detailed but slightly less similar image emerges. By pressing this button, I transfer the drawing to a new layer. You can also use this for backups from time to time. We've reached the end of this video. Thank you for watching.